Why won't you go away? Fuck! It's 3:36 in Japanese time, as of the time of filming, and I'm making a very stupid video about Android phones again. So come, Melo. It's your tech wizard's girl, Melody Tensei. Once again, we're back on talking about Android once again. If the few time has not taught me about what my channel actually wanted or the analytics ones, it's the countless numbers of times that people actually came for Android videos. So here I am talking about Android once again, or once in a long time. So let's start with something as simple as telling a story. So let's make this video a story time telling video. So it started out with me wanting to try out something very, very different with this Android phone. So as you may know, having a barely maintained ROM is not exactly ideal. The update frequency for CRDroid and PixelOS, I'm sorry Felipe, was a little longer than I was comfortable with. But with due great respects, it's a really, really hard device to take care of. Not to mention all the free times that they have sacrificed for all of us to enjoy. However, I still like to have my own choices regardless. I don't like to be locked down to something. So I thought to myself, let's try it and explore something really, really out there. So someone on my Discord server suggested to try out GSIs, which, if you don't know what GSIs are Android generic system images, which are meant to be easier for people to install different kinds of ROM and different kinds of Androids, which are basically just system images. So like kernel not included, everything not included. They have separated everything. And the OS that we all know of is known as the system images. So GSIs are basically just generic system images meant for all devices that were supported under this Google initiative called Project Treble. The main goal of Project Treble was to make driver updates and driver implementations a whole lot painless for pretty much every Android manufacturer. So it makes things more universal to some extent. Think of it like Microsoft's WHQL drivers that we currently enjoy on Windows, except more on the manufacturer side. So I thought to myself, let's try it out, considering this phone has been released well after Project Treble, which means, in theory, it is technically Treble compatible. Unfortunately, I went through a series of hurdles that included with the chaos that it came with, and that chaos is the recovery and the bootloader built into this phone. So there wasn't much documentation that could help me out. So unfortunately, I went with a very terrible path, particularly with TWRP, or TeamWin Recovery Project. And let's just say, long story short, it did not really go well at all for me. So I've spent pretty much about a week and a half now by then. And I thought to myself, okay, I give in, I give up. If I want to try out Treble, I'd like to find a device that is a whole lot simpler when it comes to recoveries and does not have proprietary recoveries that screws me over every single time. This is a hell of a phone to deal with. This, if you don't know, for those uninitiated or haven't been watching my videos in the past, this is a Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus Exynos Edition. And I'm sure the moment you hear Exynos Edition by the wording, you would realize that, this is something. Samsung proprietary this, proprietary that. Yup. Why do you think so many Android ROMs left this phone? The only specialized ROM that I know that is standing right now is currently Felipe's PixelOS, or its upstream, which is LineageOS. So LineageOS is supposed to be a pretty, pretty darn clean AOSP. So it's kind of like AOSP, kind of like how you would supposed to experience with GSIs, but made for device specifics. So like traditional custom ROMs, but feels like GSIs to some extent, but like a clean AOSP. So I went with it, and as I was going through the instructions of installing it, I reached the point where it says GApps. And the instructions from LineageOS suggested me to go through Mind the Gaps. I don't use that much Google applications. So I thought to myself, let's take a detour, because I don't know if this is possible, so I have not done my prior research, but I kind of went, you know what, I'm already risking so much for this phone anyway, so might as well just slap everything that's in there. So I went with a different GApps called Nick GApps, and I went for the core package. Yes, literally core, so core that it only has packages necessary to to run the Google Play Store. Whatever I need, like say Google Play games for games like Blue Archive, Honkai Impact, Honkai Star Rail, Genshin Impact, Xenozone Zero, I'll install that later. What I don't like, and I'm not comfortable with, is the amount of Google bloat in what Mind the Gaps has in its packages. Not to mention there's not really much choice you can do if you're sideloading with, I don't know, say Twerp or something that does not give you a option command line or something. I don't know if Mind the Gaps has an option to begin with, but I just thought to myself, you know, I've already wasted like a week and a half doing this. I just want a functional Android phone that lets me daily drive all the way. Just let me deal with GSIs on a different phone. So I went with Nick Gup's core, and by golly, after that realization, the realization that Google could take so much in the background, that this phone actually feels like it's breathing new life to it. Look at how smooth the scroll is. Let me just get into app switches. Look at it. Fuck me, this is crazy. Like, I don't know what to tell you. Say, what if I'm not a big fan of using the YouTube app? What if I just want to use YouTube on a browser? God damn it, it's super goddamn smooth. I don't think I've ever experienced the smoothness I have experienced prior to the multiple ROMs I have gone through. So that day, it dawned on me. So what if all the ROMs I've experienced prior, the lag I've experienced, the lag I've endured, all the hell I've been through with all the magisk routing modules that I've added and removed, testing left and right, all this were all pointless because the evil villain this whole time has been Google all along. This has hit me like a lightning strike. I did not for a single second thought that Google could be a culprit behind this until this. So this time around, if you're wondering what kind of things I've done to my current Android OS, which is LineageOS, what I've done is I've used a pretty nifty launcher called LaunchAir, which is basically kind of like Pixel Launcher, but with a few more additional stuff like icons and a choice of using icon packs and some customizations to the search and a few little tiny tweak peaks, I guess. It's kind of nifty, so I kind of recommend you check out on the Google Play Store or on the GitHub. But this is pretty much it. I just use LaunchAir's lawn icons and just LaunchAir as a launcher. And I got GG Murin as my wallpaper this time because G Murin, she's so adorable. Hep pet. Anyways, as for what kind of magisk modules I've installed, well, not really much. Personally, I wouldn't be rooting if it weren't for having a purpose. So because I'm using LineageOS, LineageOS actively discourages circumventing measures such as Google Play integrity and safety net. So the only way to get around it is to take care of this in our own hands. So what I pretty much did was more or less the usual thing you would expect out of a typical magisk user. So I'm using the stock magisk 28, followed by play integrity fix, Zygis. I'm only using Sui for convenience sake because there are a few Sui applications like Obtainium that could help me install things so I don't have to press the install button. You know, that's just one step extra things, you know. And followed by Zygis detach because I really don't like to update certain apps on the Play Store. But at the same time, you always have that stupid itch to press the refresh update button, but you can't because you have one app that is not updated while you have 19 more after you refresh. Well, that's pretty much it. That's really the basic simple gist of what I've done to my LineageOS. It's really that simple. There's nothing extra to it. Like, what is there? That's it. I could promote this video sponsor, SD Maid from my great old friend Darken. In fact, I'm not even gonna put the insert video that I usually do with sponsors for SD Maid. I'm just gonna do it right now here. Search. So since I have root access, it's gonna dig up even deeper than it should. And then it's gonna dig up all my previous apps, even from my previous installations, I suppose. Because look at this. Com, Samsung, Android? What in the fuck? Like guys, I genuinely swear I did not set up for this. I just legit completely forgot to wipe it out after I've installed LineageOS. And we're gonna have a little chill while we talk about what's great about SD Maid SE. SD Maid SE is currently made by an indie developer named Darken. And I gotta be honest, although he's not some big corporations like CCleaner, like by Piriform or AVG, which pretty much borrows codes from Piriform anyways, or any other cleaner, Darken My Man is kind of an honest man when it comes to creating an honest software. So do check him out on GitHub. If you have any issues, do reach out to him by issues, send him some logs, whatever he needs, because without communications, you can't get fixes done anyways. Also, if you feel like sending some short reports, like small reports that are not worth an issue ticket, feel free to check out his Discord as well. And we're gonna get into cleaning this right now. So while we wait, on top of what these three modules that I've been using, there are also deduplicator, which is kind of like, if you remember on the PC side, would be more to be called Dupe Guru, which is kind of a nifty software, I gotta be honest. Dupe Guru is kind of cool. So deduplicator is kind of like that, but on Android. And then we got app control, which you can control the apps like enabling, disabling stuff at mass, or uninstalling stuff at mass, which is what I kind of like doing a lot. In fact, you might have seen maybe a past video of me doing that, but you can mass uninstall stuff using app control, or you just wanna do something with it. I'm not really too sure because I'm not particularly a frequent user of app control, but I still think it's kind of a cool idea. If you feel like suggesting more features, please send a feature request on GitHub as well. And then we got Storage Analyzer. I remember vaguely that there's a program on Windows that everyone's using similar to that. It's pretty much similar to that. Scheduler, as the name suggests, schedules the cleaning process. If you have root, you'll be cleaning this way more thoroughly. However, if you don't have root, you may need to rely on accessibility service, but that requires your screen to be on pretty much all the time. So if my personal advice is turn off app cleaner when you're using the scheduler and just clean the apps at your own accord. All right, with the sponsor out of the way, what else do I have on my phone? Pretty much Optanium. Just for apps that I kind of want to install through GitHub, but I don't want to go through the update process by manually going to the page and stuff, Optanium is kind of helpful in that. So great props, Optanium. Though in theory, you could just get around with using F-Droid, but some apps just are not available in F-Droid. So Optanium was like a good alternative for me. And that's pretty much it, honestly. I don't think there's anything on my apps list that jumps out to you, aside from the fact that I use K9 Mail while also using Thunderbird. Sorry, I'm just kind of enthusiastic with Thunderbird stuff. It's been a lifesaver for me, especially for someone who has a lot of personal emails to take care of. And honestly, that's pretty much it, aside from Slime VR sitting there for unknown reasons that I will not elaborate on. We'll get to that eventually. But yeah, pretty much it. Aside from just grinding Blue Archive, I guess. Like, there really isn't much for me to do. I just use this phone as like my secondary grinder for Blue Archive, I guess. Oh, speaking of Blue Archive, pretty free to check out the upcoming stream tomorrow. That is tomorrow, as in the day after the publishing of this video. I'm gonna be having another Blue Archive stream. We're gonna be checking out something awesome here. So feel free to check me out there on the live tab. But yeah, on a different note, I've also completely wiped out my X account. So no more Twitter anymore, because Twitter has become a hellhole. Dare I say it. So as of today, I've moved to Blue Sky for my small and short posts that I don't feel like posting on YouTube community post. There are still posts that I still make on YouTube community post, and plenty if anything, because YouTube community post and Discord will still remain my main primary communications channel, whereas Blue Sky is gonna become my kind of like a semi-background casual communications, I guess. But I still prefer you reaching out to me on Discord or on the community post because I'm more active there. But with that said, I hope y'all keep up with me. And I'm still making some changes to my channel, so more bangers of content might be still in the works. And I'm not sure what's bangers to you anyways, but you be the judge. With that said, thank you all so much for watching. And be sure to subscribe, press the notification bell, and I don't know, maybe let me know in the comments what other video do you want me to make? Be it Android kind of video, gaming video, what else do you want? Please let me know, I genuinely need some content. But with that said, done with story times, I'm gonna wrap up my recording and relax for another week, I suppose. Nah, just joking, I'll be making more videos, fuck it. And I'll see you guys next time. Otsumeda deshita. Peace!